Before teaching you the book, journal entries in the books of consigning, let me teach you in both in consignment as well as what consigning. Whenever we send the goods on consignment, first entry will be for what sending the goods. The entry is consignment to goods sent on consignment in the books of consigner. Whereas in the books of consigning, there is no entry. But you should understand why there is no entry. Here the ownership is, try to understand whether the ownership is transferred to the consignee or not. Because the ownership is non-transferred, because the consignee only is the real owner of the goods, there is no entry in the books of consignee. Next, so when you send the goods, there is no entry in the books of consignee as the ownership is not transferred from consignor to consignee. Second, for expenses met by consignor, the consignor is paying the expense, so entry, all the expense should be debited to consignment to cash in the books of consignor. But for the consignee, there is no entry because he is not making any payment. He is not concerned about it. Third one, advance. For advance given by the consignee. Now the consignee is giving you the advance. When you get the advance in the books of consignor, we are receiving cash or check or bills receivable. Who is the giver? Consignee. For the consignee. Consignee, who is the receiver for consignee? Consignor is the receiver. He is paying to, he is giving the advance in the form of check or he is accepting a bill. If he accepts a bill, you write two bills payable. If he gives a check, you write what? Two bank. Fourth one is for what? Sales. When the sales is made by the consignee, the entry is what? Consignee to consignment in the books of consignor. Whereas in consigning, if you receive cash, if the consignee receives cash from the customers, the entry is what? Cash account data to consignor. If it is on credit, he will write debtors to consignor. Because they are debtors, so debtors shows what balance? Debit balance. Debtors to consignor. For expenses met by consignee, the entry is all the expenses should be debited to consignment to consignee. Here consignee is what? Creditor. For consignee, because he has paid the expenses, he has to get the reimbursement from consignor. Then the consignor will become our debtor. That's why we are debiting whom? Consignor. Consignor account data to cash. For commission payable to consignee, when you have to pay commission, the entry is what? All the expenses in the books of consignor should be debited to consignment to consignee. Commission has to be given by whom? Consignor. When the consignor has to give us commission, he becomes our debtor. The entry is consignor account debtor to commission is the income, so we are crediting what? Commission. For unsold stock, the entry is consignment stock to consignment. Here there is no entry. Profit or loss, the consignor is here, the profit or loss belongs to whom? Consignor, not to the consignee, so no entry in the books of consignee. For settlement, now at the end of the year he has to settle the account, so the consignee has to pay the amount. So when he pays the amount, what we are getting, the consignee is getting? He is getting a check or bills receivable, credit the giver, consignee. What will the consignee write? Debit the receiver, consignor. He is paying through check, so consignor account data to bank. So what are the entries we are writing in the books of consignee? When we send the goods, there is no entry in the books of consignee because the consignee is not, the ownership is not transferred. Second one, for expenses made by consignor, there is no entry in the books of consignee because it is paid by consignor. Third one, advance. When the consignee is paying advance to consignor, who is the receiver? Consignor is the receiver. We are paying through check. Check both the cash is going out of check and we are giving a bills payable, so two bills payable is going out.